Hello, and welcome to the Exponential Smoothing tutorial series. In our last few tutorials, we discussed how to construct one or multiple steps out of a sample forecast, and the calibration process for smoothing parameters for holt-winters triple exponential smoothing. Now, we'll demonstrate how to calculate fitted or in-sample forecasts and its components, level, trend, and seasonal indices. For sample data, we will use a popular textbook example, the monthly international airline passengers data set. First, select the cell E11. Type in the triple exponential function name, equals TESMTH, open parentheses. Once you find the function, click on the FX button found on the left side of the equation toolbar. This will invoke the function arguments dialog box for the triple exponential smoothing function. For the input data, select the cell range corresponding to the whole demand volume sample data, which is C11 to C103. Then lock the cell range by pressing F4. For the time order in the input data, type in true or 1 to designate the first observation as the earliest observation. For the level smoothing parameter, alpha, you can type in a value or reference an existing cell. In this example, let's reference the value in D1, and then lock the cell by pressing F4. For the trend smoothing parameter beta, you can type in a value or reference an existing cell. In this example, let's reference the cell in D2, and then lock the cell by pressing F4. For the seasonal indices smoothing parameter gamma, you can type in a value or reference an existing cell. In this example, let's reference the value in D3. And then lock the cell reference by pressing F4. For the seasonal length or duration, you can type in a positive integer or reference an existing cell. In this example, let's reference the cell value of D5. And lock the cell by pressing F4. For the optimization switch, leave it disabled by referencing the D4 cell. And lock the cell reference by pressing F4. For forecast time, type in or select a cell with the value of the number of steps past the end of the data to include. Then lock the cell reference by pressing F4. For return type, type in 4 for the one step in sample level component series. Then click OK. The function returns the first value in the array. To display the whole array, select the cells starting with E11 and all rows below it. Then press F2 to edit the formula. Hold down Ctrl, Shift, and then Enter. The selected cells are now populated with the array values, and the formula is surrounded by italic braces. Now, let's plot the level component over time. And do the same for the trend component. To make it easier this time, let's copy the formula from E11, so select E11 and copy the cell to F11. And now we need to edit the formula in F11 and change the return type. So select the cell F11 and then click on the FX button found on the left side of the equation toolbar. The function arguments dialog box for the triple exponential function will pop up. Leave all arguments intact and then go to the return type field and change the value from 4 to 5, and then click OK. The function returns the first value in the trend component array. To display the whole array, select the cells starting with F11 and all rows below it. Then press F2 to edit the formula. Hold down Ctrl and Shift, and then hit Enter. The selected cells are now populated with the array values, and the formula is surrounded by italic braces. Let's plot the trend component over time. Let's do the same for the seasonal indices component. To make it easier this time, let's copy the formula from F11. Select the cell F11 and copy it to the cell G11. Now we need to edit the formula in G11 and change the return type. So select the cell G11, and then click on the FX button found on the left side of the equation toolbar. The function arguments dialog box for the triple exponential function will pop up. Leave all arguments intact and go to the return type field and change the value from 5 to 6. Then click OK. The function returns the first value in the seasonal indices component array. To display the whole array, select the cell starting with G11 and all rows below it. Press F2 to edit the formula. Hold down Ctrl and Shift, then hit Enter. The selected cells are now populated with the array values and the formula is surrounded by italic braces. Let's plot the seasonal indices component over time. And now we'll repeat the same process for the in sample forecast component. So select the cell G11 and copy it into cell H11. Select the H11 cell and click on the FX button. In the triple exponential function arguments dialog box, change the return type value from 6 to 7, and then click OK. The function returns the first value in the forecast component array. To display the whole array, select the cell starting with H11 and all rows below it. Then press F2 to edit the formula. Hold down Ctrl, Shift, and then hit Enter. The selected cells are now populated with the array values, and the formula is surrounded by italic braces. Finally, let's plot the forecast component over time. That's all for now. Thank you for watching.